Madam, how can we thank you? Your celebrations in honor of the fatherland could hardly have been more superlatively pontifical.
Oh, thank you, Your Excellency.
Bit, my dear.
Can you keep a diplomatic secret?
A diplomatic secret? Go on.
I've prepared a special surprise for Count Danilo. I understand he's interested in the nightlife of Paris. Places like Maxime's. So I've specially engaged the very little grisette.
Aye, did he engaging, Excellency, and most engaging it was.
What real grisettes to come here?
Alive and high kicking, Your Excellency, by your leave. They are Lolo, Dodo, Fru Fru.
Oh, not old Fru Fru.
This is her daughter, Excellency.
Oh, yes.
Tonight, after supper, my garden will be transformed as if by magic. It will be like a dream, Chez Maxime. So you must promise me to stay.
You like it, madam?
The best is to come.
I shall be there. Now, Negus, quickly tell me. Do you think she's beginning to feel drawn towards the Count? Do you think my plan is working out after all?
Odds are even.
But why isn't that scoundrel Danilo here?
He's not coming at all.
What?
As far as he's concerned, the whole party can go to blaze, as he said.
But you pointed out that his attendance here was a duty? I hope. An official duty from the fatherland?
The fatherland is beginning to get him down, he said.
Dear me, dear. This is high treason. Last night, I myself explained to him the patriotic nature of his mission. He fully understood.
Then he must have changed his mind. Wild horses wouldn't drag him here, he said.
Wild? But this is an outrage,
that's what he said.
My dear Baron.
But here he is.
My dear Baron, my removal operations have been indefatigable.
And conspicuously unsuccessful.
No, not conspicuously.
I don't believe we even know the name of the man who was the real menace to my plan.
No. Who?
Well, I suspect Camille de Rosio.
Camille? I don't believe it.
Neither do I.
Why not? He's the best looking man in Paris, the best dressed, the worst off. A bachelor, always in debt. Besides, I've had my eye on him. De Rosio's our danger spot, you mark my words.
But, Your Excellency, I happen to know he's already madly in love with a married woman.
And pray, who is this married woman?
Well, he didn't actually tell me that.
Oh, he didn't. Oh, well, we'll trace her through diplomatic channels. If we can find the unscrupulous harpy that's ensnared him, then she'll have to marry him.
The mere threat of marriage should be enough to put him off. But what's the poor woman's husband going to say to all this?
Ah, the husband? I shall deal with him personally. Obviously, the man's an ass. Oh, there is De Rosio with my wife. What luck! Now, she seems to have some influence over him.
Yes, she does, doesn't she?
You know, Your Excellency, she could help us a lot.
You think so, Negus?
Yes, indeed.
Well, in that case, listen. I suggest that my wife be instructed to work on De Rosio's feelings. And she's been working on mine long enough. And possibly what... Why are you looking at me like that?
I wasn't looking at you like that, Excellency. What do you suggest?
Well, as I just said, I suggest that my wife be instructed to work under Rosion's feelings. You know my wife as well as I. And possibly with that tact and charm of diplomacy here and there, one never knows where the whole thing may lead to, and eventually the category... But you're still looking at me like that.
Oh, Excellency, go on talking. I'll look the other way.
Well, my wife must get him to renounce his infatuation for Madame Glavari, then wed the married woman he really loves. Now, that doesn't sound too difficult to me.
No, quite simple.
Now, run along and ask Her Excellency to be so good as to wait for me. Say I must speak with her or something.
Certainly, Your Excellency.
Yes. Now, what's your theory about all this?
Well, I'm Fox.
What?
Good evening.
Yes, Frank.
Good evening. Charming, charming. Who was that?
Olga Kromov.
Ah! Kromov, of course! Then perhaps this fan may help us to a clue. It belongs to Madame Kromov, at least I think it does. Yes, yes. It's got written here upon it, I love you.
So it has. Yes. Large as life.
Yes, yes.
And it's Camille's handwriting.
Yes, my dear Count.
We're getting hot.
We are, my dear Count, we are. This matter is vital. I shall leave it in your diplomatic hands. I shall expect... results! Oh, for heaven's
sake. Camille. Camille de Rossillon. But who's the lady friend? Olga? I doubt it. We shall see.
Count Danilovich. What a surprise! You've been avoiding me. Why?
Military tactics, Madame Glavari.
Of course I forgot. Where enemy powers? As your mortal foe, I feel singularly unscathed.
Only light skirmishes so far. The heavy artillery will follow.
Oh, must it? Quarrels were tiresome occupation.
I'm not quarreling. I'm just avoiding you.
You didn't avoid me once. Remember our drives after the farm?
They were my undoing.
There are still plenty of one horse gigs in Paris.
Too risky.
Not even brave enough to take the tiniest little risk.
If that was a sniping shot, it misfired badly.
And there's still a lot of Paris I haven't seen, you know.
Really? Then let me show you.
Dear Blessy, here we are. Off we go, but not too far. Take us down the boulevard, jogging so sedately. Dear Blessy, not so slow. Grunts and jingle as we go. Take the road, oh lovers know. Lots have been there lately.
Madam, here's your evening shawl. Maybe chilly after ten. Grassy plot, we shall stay here, rain or not, chatting quite contented.
Oh!
Easy now, you've jumped too fast. That's the place we've trotted past. Now's the time to halt at last. Madam has consented.
So I feel pain and ease.
Gladly, madam, as you please. Luckily, I've lost the track.
Jogging in a one-horse gig, saying what you long to say. Titillating, teasing,
mutually pleasing. Lovers falling love that way. Destination heaven, jogging back to earth next day.
Isn't you and I, though?
Wish we didn't sigh so.
Now it's not for us, no.
Think so?
Charming. And what were you doing, may I ask?
Deciding not to go for a ride in the bois.
Charming.
Stop saying charming in that inane fashion. And take that expression off your face.
Oh, my expressions are not very successful today.
Now for the diplomatic coup.
Yes, sir.
Take pencil,
yes,
notebook.
Yes, sir.
Stand by and stand back.
Yes, sir.
My azaleas are certainly not what they were in 1900.
Madame, come off. Excuse me a moment.
Come! Oh, excuse that, please.
I think you have lost something.
Oh, I don't think so.
Ah, but you have your heart. And also another little, shall we say, trinket?
What do you mean?
It's her. I found it. Don't be alarmed. You can rely on me in all matters of discretion, but, may I take the liberty of giving you a slight warning? He is on the point of marrying someone else. In fact, the widow.
Who? Sadler.
What?
Oh, what? Oh, thank you, dear Count. Oh, dear. Oh, dear.
No, it isn't her. Negus, yes, put down Olga Kromov and Sabriosh.
He was coming up, Sadler.
Oh, so madame, excuse me a moment. I think you have lost something.
Surely not.
No, I think I'm correct. It is your heart.
Oh, nonsense.
And also something else. Something you can roll up.
Something I can roll up?
Uh-huh. Would be her whole victory. Set your mind at rest. I can be trusted with a lady's confidence. But allow me to give you a piece of timely advice. Abandon him. He is about to marry the widow.
Cascadon?
Casco who?
Oh, really. Thank you, dear Count.
Well, thank you.
Thank you very much.
What a lot of tidbits one finds out from a few harmless questions here and there. Oh, Yigas, Madame Simon and Cascara.
Got that. Next, please.
Well, this is certainly Camille's handwriting, but who's the lady friend? Well, I'm narrowing it down. Prascovia! Surely it couldn't be her.
What a beautiful fan.
Yes, it is indeed a beautiful thing. Chinese, would you say?
Oh, I would.
And on it is written, you will observe, I love you.
Oh!
May I place it in the dainty hand of the owner?
Lord, Angus! Dear Danilo, did you guess or did you know?
Angus, this could be sensational. Ah, madame, know what?
How very near and dear to me you are.
Angus, what did she say?
You!
How old do you think I am?
Oh, much older than you look. How old than you are, Angus?
Madam, your husband.
My husband? Where?
Oh, coming this way.
Oh, dear Count, I may rely on your discretion.
Oh, surely. Amen. Oh. But whose is this confounded fan?
What shall I do with all this information, sir?
Oh, send it in the diplomatic bag to London. It will entertain the Foreign Office.
I warn you, Sandrios, you had better leave the widow alone. I am a capable swordsman.
And I am a crack shot.
No.
This is where I get rid of these two for good and all. Let me have your notes. Now go, dear boy. It may be dangerous round here.
And if you think you're going to cook my goose, sir.
Cook your goose, sir!
Yes, cook my goose!
Gentlemen, spoiling for a tip.
Tip?
As it happens, Monsieur Cascara, I've been meaning to have a few words with Madame Glavari about you.
Oh, about me?
Uh-huh.
Oh, nice.
And about you too, sir.
And me? Oh.
I feel obliged to inform Madame Glavari that very probably a duel will be fought this evening between Vicomte Cascara and... Excuse me, sir. Nikolai Bogdanovich!
Bogdanovich!
I fear he has found out all about you and his wife!
Good heavens, no! Oh, damn!
Well, you seem to have cooked his goose all right!
Yes, and yours is nearly ready for the oven. I feel impelled to inform Madame Glavari that very probably a duel will be fought this evening between you and, excuse me, sir, Alexis Kromov!
Kromov?
He has found out all about you and his wife!
A thousand devils!
Gentlemen, look who's here!
Oh, no, really, sir, you won't.
Didio, don't be rash!
I've just been discussing a little domestic problem with these two friends of mine. I suppose it all depends on the character of the injured party, how a man should act on discovering that his wife is indulging in a little, how shall I say, a little flutter.
Oh, simple enough, I should have thought.
Really, what's your view?
As far as I'm concerned, the rascal would be a corpse in no time.
A corpse, sir? Mincemeat!
Corpse!
Mincemeat!
Champagne, monsieur.
No, brandy. Make it a double.
Make mine a treble.
Please deliver this card to Madame Glavari.
Say flowers will follow.
I'm off to Nicaragua.
Nicaragua? Where the devil's that,
sir? The faintest idea, but I'm going there.
So am I!
No!
Jump!
Gentlemen, what are you debating so hotly?
The management of women, Your Excellency.
Ah, nutty point, that nutty point.
And what a husband should do if his wife takes a lover.
Oh, well, thank heaven they haven't to worry about things of that sort.
It's a problem.
It's a problem.
How to manage
to go on.
How to manage willful women when the bloom of love has gone.
How to keep them?
Keep them faithful
is the question.
We're about to.
If there's any bright suggestion,
we're ready to try it out.
Now,
Now one prefers the latest fashion,
quaffer, hip line, toque, and muff,
and one the grand romantic passion,
twister, and is all the stuff.
The next demands a bull-neck hero,
spurs and wax pistachio,
with brawn and plus and brain at zero,
Ajax or Petruchio.
The fourth is fractious late and early,
strolling when the guests are gone,
still thriving in the hurdy-burdy,
offspring of an Amazon.
But some, of course, are sweet and tender,
snakes that wheel and revive. We'll close our ranks and not surrender, wondering what to do meanwhile.
What to think, what to say, what to do,
all these women,
what a red letter day if we knew,
all these women,
being male, we may fail, but we try. Yes, we try,
try, try, try, try.
Clutching hope, we must cope as we can.
All these women,
though it's plainly too much for a man.
All these women,
though you sweat, though you slave, they forget what you gave them, you're back where you first began. Women, women, women,
women, women, women, women, women, women, women,
women, women, women, women,
women, women. Oh. What to think?
What to say, what to do,
women, women, women,
what
women,
a red letter day if we knew,
women, women,
be brave, we may fail, but we try,
women, women,
yes we try,
try, try, try, try, clutching hope, we must hope as we can, though it's plainly too much for a man, though you sweat, though you slay, then forget what you did and your best when you must be.
Is aspersion
false and wild?
We admit in certain persons
the maid is a problem child.
When Shatter joins a drinking session,
be it whiskey, wine, or beer,
he makes a rather very precious
swinging from the chandelier.
And claims upon whom he was prone to
never gives his wife a thought.
Makes him wealthy, his wife he'd known to
keep a wife in every port.
Not only drinks but gambles,
leaves his loving spouse at home,
then loses all on midnight rambles,
comes back reeking of cologne.
But women are the greater problem,
snakes and wheel and beguile. We can but share our common burden, wondering what to do meanwhile.
What to think, what to say, what to do,
all these women,
what a red letter day if we knew,
all these women,
being men, we may fail, but we try, yes, we try,
try, try, try, try,
clutching hope, we must cope as we can,
all these women,
though it's plainly too much for a man,
all these women,
though you sweat, though you slay, they forget what you gain, then you're back where you first began.
Women, 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 women. Oh. What to think, what to say, what to do, what a plan to make if we do, be a man with a man of the time. Yes, we try, 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 catch a book in a sport as we can.
Women,
women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women, women
Strange.
What's more, it's odd that they should simultaneously have to leave for Nicaragua. And so suddenly.
Nicaragua is a place one either goes to suddenly or not at all.
Why are you grinning like a demented Cheshire cat?
I rather feel I've won this round.
Oh, on the contrary. You have succeeded in removing the two that were the least dangerous. There are others.
Others?
May I ask why you're going to all this trouble, or would that be crime?
I have an irresistible urge to remove people and things. Always have.
I see. Even if you're not in love with me, you're...
Out of the question.
I was going to say, even if you don't love
Absolutely out of the question.
Please let me finish. I do hope that I may have the benefit of your advice.
Advice?
In all honesty.
Well?
As to whether or not I should marry someone whose proposal I'm seriously considering. Oh, it is, of course, someone I admit I want to marry.
Well, marry him if you really want him so much. Mm-hmm. That's my advice. Marry whoever you want. This doesn't hurt me. Damn this family.
There's no need to shout and scream.
And I'll be happy to dance at your wedding like a dervish.
But why shouldn't you? Can you tell me that? Oh, but why bother to ask? You're still jealous.
That's just it.
What did you say?
I find I'm always jealous of a woman who grows fond of one of my friends.
I understand.
So you needn't look so pleased with yourself, Anna Glavari.
Oh, I hate you. Ladies first. What's this? I love you. Who can it be meant for? But of course it's for me. He wrote it down and put the fan there for me to find. But he has got to say it to me.
Well, have you cooled down?
What do you mean? I wasn't upset.
No?
But if you're quite in control of yourself, then I can safely tell you something. I have finally decided to become a Parisian.
Poor old fatherland. Bango, 20 millions.
But before settling down to married life, I should like to go about a little, see places and learn a little more about Paris, I mean. Where does one go to amuse oneself these days?
With one's fiancé. To a soirée, I would suggest, at the Pontevedrian Embassy.
I might find that dull.
Exhilarating, I assure you. They do folk dances.
I wouldn't think much of that.
No, would I?
I didn't come to Paris for that sort of thing. And besides, I'm not your fiancé, am I?
Yes, that's true.
So you could take me somewhere gay.
At Maxime's once again, I swim in pink champagne.
Maxime's?
I must explain. At Maxime's, there will doubtless be very excellent dancing by young ladies of very doubtful reputation. And when you enter on my arm, everyone will think, ha-ha, the new Gazette, what a feat! Monocles will flash, and I'll be the target of envious glances. The band strikes up a waltz. Three bars, no more, and you've abandoned three quarters of your principles. Carried away by the music, you fly into the arms of one man after another, and before you know where you are, you find yourself in the embraces of a madly attractive waiter. Of course, he will introduce himself. I am the Grand Duke of Briansk.
Excellency.
The moment I clapped eyes on you, I was visited with an overpowering spiritual malaise. You may have heard, we Russians are prone to such things. But you are unimpressed. Disgruntled, he bows and retreats in good order.
Well, he has certainly danced with me. But what has he said? Nothing at all.
Well, she certainly danced with me. But where has he gone me? Nowhere at all. Well, there it is. So where do we go from here?
Oh, that's up to you, sir.
Very well, then. The Moulin Rouge!
And what do we do there?
What do we do there? Why dance, of course.
Mm.
listen to this. I have asked my wife to spy into Rosion, and she's consented. You see, I know how to get things done. There they are now, both of them. But this way, you fool. See how she flirts and gazes into his eyes? Splendid woman. Exemplary wife, I'll bet you anything before tonight we'll have the name we're after.
Your Excellency, an express letter.
Oh. Ah, from the Ministry. It's in code, decode it. No, I'll do it. Read it.
Zwing.
The Ministry?
Zwang.
Would be obliged?
Zwang.
For your promptest?
Zwang.
Reply?
Vazeldom.
Idiot, it's the watermark.
My apologies, Excellency.
Granted.
The word this time is certainly scunchy.
Regarding?
Zwang.
The 20 melons.
Melons?
Melons.
Millions. Oh.
He's guessed it. Well, as you see, this letter refers to the Glavari melons.
Millions!
The Ministry now regarding it as a matter of urgency. At any rate, we're obliged to submit a report forthwith. At all costs, let us not be too hasty. Now, for this, I should need you both. Now, let me see. It's now 7:45. Now, meet me there in that little pavilion at 8:00 sharp. Then we can draft this telegram uninterrupted. 8:00 sharp, is that clear?
Understood.
I know it's understood. Is it clear?
Irrefutably.
And of course, what did he say?
He says he understands.
Understands what?
What you said.
But I never said anything.
I beg your pardon. I thought you did.
My dear fellow, please don't apologize. As a matter of fact, between you and I, I'm sorry I didn't. Oh, she's still there. Not letting DeRozan out of her sight. Wait, they're coming this way. Let us leave her to continue the good work.
Oh, looks to me as though she's really doing excellent work.
You think so?
I do.
Bravo. Splendid.
Camille, my husband knows you're in love with someone. He's determined to find out who it is. Now, more than ever, we must bring this to an end.
If it must be so. At least let me have some little keepsake. That will be a constant reminder of our love.
A keepsake?
Look, Valencia, isn't this your friend?
It is. Oh, thank heavens at last. You shall have this as a memento.
What are you writing?
I'm a highly respectable wife, and I love my husband. Here's your keepsake, my Camille.
Oh, Valencia.
Camille, my dear.
Must you torment me?
You know I want to get you married, so you must speak to Anna now, this evening.
I understand, yet it is you I long for. Let us go.
morning shine, let me sing my serenade. Then part, night will see a joy, but no tongue ever turned.
Together, in the dark.
Oh, dear.
Oh, dear.
Well, Negus, it's past the hour of rendezvous.
Just on 8, Excellency, just on 8.
But where's Count Danilo?
Not here yet. By your leave, let us wait out here where it's so remarkably fresh.
Oh, fresh.
Nothing like fresh air when you're out of doors, sir.
Why wait? Let us proceed with the telegram in the quiet of the pavilion.
Excellency, Excellency, by your leave.
What is this silly shallying?
Excellency, someone is in there. It's engaged.
Engaged? Who is it? Not a woman?
Of sorts.
You mean a lady?
Good Lord, no. I mean, yes.
Yes, I know what you're trying to hide. And I can guess who's in there with her, your own precious count. Am I right, you dog, you?
Monsieur de Rosion, my count?
What?
Oh, dear, what have I said?
De Rosion with a lady. Bravo. We have caught him at last. Negus,
you shall be promoted for this. We have caught him with a married woman he's in love with. From now on, everything will be plain sailing.
Plain sinking.
Negus, quickly. That little pavilion has a door at the back. Go and lock it.
Oh, dear. First take him out, then lock it.
Oh, dear me, I just can't wait. Ah, my dear Count, you're just in time for the denouement. I have traced the Rosen's lady.
Who is she?
That's for surprise. I don't exactly know. But she's in there now. And Negus has slipped down the back and locked the door. Come, let us do a little eavesdropping.
Not me.
I can hear him talking.
Your Excellency, that isn't done in the best diplomatic circles.
Oh, that's all right. Ours aren't the best. He's still talking. He's talking of the marriage to which his love must be sacrificed. Oh, it's heartbreaking.
The lady?
I'll take a...
Your Excellency, that isn't done even in the second best circles.
I've just done it. Dear, I can't see her face. She's standing with her back to the keyhole. What's the betting is the good lady wife of that pompous ass Cromwell?
Oh, no betting.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Oh. Shh, quiet. Now she's turning round.
Who is it, Your Excellency?
Come,
look at myself.
No, don't look. I forbid it to you. Don't look.
Who is it?
My wife.
Your what?
Oh, did Cromwell through the pompous old ass.
So she was coming as lover.
Oh, dear.
Your Excellency, I've no doubt at all that you're mistaken.
I've just seen it there, my dear fellow. No,
well, if you're not, there's still one consolation I can offer.
Oh, cause it possible. No,
you're suffering for the fatherland.
Damn the fatherland!
Damn the green fatherland!
Open up there! Open up! I knew for certain what I saw.
Camille, this be ridiculous. The blackest moment of my life.
But where the nurse, my wife?
You want me?
Well, this knocks me flat.
What happened, someone? Tell me that.
Anna and Camille.
I plainly saw a woman standing there when I was peeping through the door.
A most uncivil thing to do.
What's more, I plainly heard the gentleman who stand before me declare his love.
You heard him speak to me.
I could have sworn it was my faithless wife.
My darling Camille, you must bear me
up. But let us all come back and confess.
It seems that the Baron thought it meet to spy on his friends and me in this retreat. So you, my Camille, must bravely repeat the secrets you told me so meltingly sweet.
Must I obey you? The whole truth I pray you. She has commanded. Of what is my lord?
What?
He had better make this good.
Red as the rose of Maytime that blooms in brighter air. Love in my heart was opened and charmed my tears away. Such trust my waking eyes. It seemed I still lay dreaming, yet walked in upon a paradise. I know of your desire and presence every summer sky, but though the winds are little felicity is worth consideration. From close observation, the marriage tie is obsolete. The wedded pair is incomplete. The pattern, though twofold, soon becomes a threesome. Triangular adjustable, or rather too combustible. To prove my point, you ought to see some. One final point, then nothing more. Take my advice, keep open door. When marriage calls, give it an airy. Take care to clear the coast a bit, then take your chance and make the most of it. Soul and body away. For shame, cried the prince, you have wronged me, mistaken, unfeeling, and blind. You show by this deed you're no better than all your false feminine kind. But never imagine I'm grieving. He showed not a sign. No treachery past my believing. These words were the prince's, not mine. this fury then rose to its climax. Go, take him, you'll quickly repent. And so with that blessing he left her, but curse in his heart as he went.
You're going, Count, but where?
Where? No one seems to want me. I'm off to Chemexine to join the world extreme. When people ask for places, I simply tell them this is low, low, do, do, zoo, zoo, clo, clo, margo, frou, frou. And when it comes,